Hi there, welcome to my channel. If this is your first time on this channel, you are so welcome. And if you are a returning subscriber, you are just as welcome. It's always nice to make these videos for you guys. Today we're going to be having a very interesting discussion, and we shall be talking about social media, particularly how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media. Everybody is on social media, I guess. Maybe not everybody, but you get the drift, right? So if you're watching this video, I know there's a very high chance that you are one of the billions of users on social media. And as you're having a good time online, going through profiles, there's a high chance that you'll come across the profile of somebody that you like, someone that tickles your fancy, and you would want to get in touch with them. There's nothing wrong with that. We meet people off social media, so what stops us from meeting people on social media? And shooting your shot in DMs has become a thing. Nowadays, everybody's looking for the best ways to get across to that special person that they have found online. Sometimes you might be looking for a romantic relationship with that person, and other times you just want friendship. Whatever the case may be, you need to go about it the right way. Otherwise, you will not get their attention. They would kick you out of their DM if you don't press the right buttons, if you don't pander to their emotions in the right way. So on this video, I will be giving you all the tips on how to shoot your shots in DMs the right way. I can assure you that if you followed these tips, that person that you're trying to get to talk to, whose attention you're looking for, would be happy to indulge you. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, this is a very good time to do so, okay? And please don't forget to turn on the notification so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. If you're ready, I am ready. So let's dive into it. The first tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to be ready for the outcome. You need to understand that there is no guarantee that what you want to do is going to work out successfully. Nope, there is no guarantee. You are the one looking for something. You are the one looking for a relationship or just friendship. The person you're reaching out to might not be looking for the same, so you can't tell how they are going to react to your action. So to avoid feeling depressed, feeling bad about a rejection, you need to be prepared that there's a very high chance that rejection might happen. Oh yes, so if they don't give you the attention that you're looking for, how do you accept it? How do you live with it? If you're one of those people that don't know how to handle rejection, perhaps shooting your shot in DMs on social media is not for you, okay? You need to look elsewhere. It is for the strong-hearted, those who do not mind even if they are rejected. And the thing about that is, if you're rejected, it could mess with your head. It could really affect you, okay? So you need to think it through. Are you okay with the rejection? If you are, then it's fine to go ahead with it. But if you're not, I will advise you to avert that plan, okay? Just forget about it so that you don't get yourself messed up. The second tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to follow the person. Okay, if you're going to slide into someone's DM, the least you can do is to follow them. Now, when you follow them, you are trying to get their attention, okay? The third tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to like just a few of their photos, not all of them. I know that you like this person, you like what you see, and you want them to know that you like what you see, right? But you don't need to like all their posts. You know why? That is creepy. Imagine having about 50 or 100 posts on your profile, on your page, and then somebody you don't know is suddenly liking all your posts. What will be your first reaction? It will creep you out. So you don't want to creep that person out, okay? Yes, you want to let them know that you are on their page by liking just a few of their posts, all right? You could like the first five posts that they made, that is okay. Don't do it too much because you're going to come across as creepy and crazy. And trust me, nobody wants to be with somebody that is creepy, especially because they don't even know you. Yes, you might be a really sweet person, but to this person, you are a complete stranger, okay? So don't give them a wrong impression about you. Let them see you, like just a few of their posts to make them see you, but don't overdo it, all right? Remember, you're trying to get their attention. Once you have their attention, with just a few posts, liking a few posts, you can proceed to mesmerize them with your awesomeness. We're still talking about how to shoot your shots in DMs on social media, or better still, how to slide into DMs on social media. And the fourth tip is use interesting icebreakers. You need to remember that you are a total stranger to this person. They don't know you, okay? So you can't just walk up to them and say, hey, what's up? 1,000 other people might have told them the same line. Hey, what's up? They're not your friend, okay? So there's nothing interesting about that line to get their attention. And if you're not lucky, they could ignore you completely. And I know that that is a bad feeling. Nobody wants to be ignored. So why don't you get a little bit creative and come up with more interesting icebreakers? Don't just say, hey, how are you? They don't know you, so why should they be telling you how they feel or how they are? Think of something, okay? Take a look at their profile. You could comment on a particular post. Say something about a particular post. Let's say they have a pet. You could use that. You could say, hey, that's a nice dog you have there, if they have a dog in their photo. That's a good way to start. If they are swimming, for instance, you could say something about swimming. If you love swimming too, you could say something along those lines, just to get their attention, just to let them know that both of you share something in common. That way they are more inclined to respond to you. Remember, in the first place, they are not obligated. They don't owe you anything. They don't have to respond. So you need to give them a reason to respond. So be interesting. Say something that would, you know, prick them a little. Something that would make them want to say something. All right? Don't be boring. Hey, how are you? No. That is so old school. That is so traditional, okay? I know you're smart, so go through their posts and find something that you could use to break the ice. I tell you, if it's interesting, they will be so interested in responding to you. And before you know it, both of you will be having a very fun and interesting conversation. The fifth tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to avoid Shatner texting them. In case you don't know what that means, it means to not bombard them with messages, okay? Send one message or maybe two messages and hold on, okay? If they want to respond to you, they will respond the moment they come online and see your messages. Sending them multiple messages will not make them respond if they don't want to. It will only creep them out. Remember, this person owes you nothing. So you can't force them to respond to you. No, you can't. The best you can do is to send one or two messages and then hold on for them to respond. If you bombard them with a series of messages non-stop, they might even block you because that is so creepy. You are invading their privacy. So the least you can do is to take it easy, okay? Don't overwhelm them with your messages. I know you have so much you want to say to them, but calm down, okay? Just take it easy. If it's meant to happen, it will happen. They will respond. They're probably busy. Yes, they have a life. They're not sitting down expecting messages to come in so they can respond to the messages immediately. No. And don't even start talking about them being online. You can see them online, but they are not responding to your messages. Remember, they owe you nothing. They can choose to be online and not respond to you. There is nothing wrong with that, okay? You need to accept that and live with it. So to avoid being ignored, ensure that your icebreakers are very interesting. Nobody would ignore an interesting icebreaker. All right, send one or two messages and then hold on. If they will respond, they will. Don't creep them out. No, seriously, don't do that, okay? The sixth tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to be moderate with your compliments. I know you are crazy about this person. You like everything you have seen. You love their photos. You want to be friends with them. You want to get to know them. So you're excited, and there's a tendency for you to, you know, throw all sorts of compliments at them. That's okay. I mean, everybody would appreciate a good compliment. But when your compliments are overboard, you're doing it too much, it becomes obvious that you're just flattering them. Okay, so keep the compliments moderate. Hey, you look beautiful. Hey, I like your clothes. I like this and I like that. That's it. Don't overdo it. Okay, when you overdo it, you begin to make them feel uncomfortable, like they are some sort of idol. Okay, you don't want to idolize anybody. That is so creepy. Just say a few compliments and zip it. Okay, if you have nothing else to say, nothing interesting to say any further, just zip it. Otherwise, you might end up creeping them out with your compliments. The seventh tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to avoid asking personal questions. You should also avoid bringing up discussions about sensitive subjects like religion, politics, sexuality, etc. The eighth tip on how to shoot your shot in DMs on social media is to be yourself. Don't try to impress anybody too much, okay? Just be yourself, because when you're trying to impress, you might end up telling all sorts of lies just to make yourself look good in front of that person. And at the end of the day, your lies might come to the fore and they will see you for a liar. You might not be a liar. You might just be trying to get in their good graces, in their good books. So you should avoid that in the first place, okay? Say things the way that they are, okay? If you're asked any questions, answer them honestly. Remember, you can't force friendships, you can't force relationships. Anybody who doesn't like you for who you are isn't meant for you, isn't meant to be in your life. At the end of the day, if both of you are meant to be together or be friends, whatever the case might be, it will work out. They will love you and admire you and respect you for the person that you are. That is way better than being found out to be a very big liar. The next time you come across that profile on social media and you like the person, nothing should stop you from sliding right into their DM, okay? Go ahead and shoot your shot. If you follow these tips that I have discussed here, I can assure you that the outcome will be good. At the end of the day, everybody wants to be with somebody interesting. And if you come across as that person, I can assure you that they would be happy to welcome you with open arms. My name is Chris once again. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, this is a very good time to do so. Please don't forget to turn on the notification so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. I recently made an interesting video titled "What Your Body Count Says About You." You can find it right here. Trust me, you don't want to miss that video. Go ahead and watch it and let me know what you think about it. I'm looking forward to reading your comments about shooting your shot in DMs on social media, okay? So please feel free to drop a comment down below. I'll be reading every comment and responding accordingly. See you on the next video. Have a good day.